In this screencast, we're going to use the Kremser analysis to determine the number of equilibrium stages required in an absorption system. In this particular absorption system, we're taking chloroform and air and trying to remove the chloroform from the air and put it into a water stream. It's important to note that we can also do the same analysis using a graphical method, as shown here. For more information on the graphical analysis, follow the link here. The Kremser analysis is a non-graphical method used to determine the number of stages required in an absorption system. It can be also applied to any other system where you have multiple stages you're stepping off, where both the equilibrium information, or the equilibrium line, and the operating line are linear. The first step in the Kremser analysis is to convert the equilibrium information into a standardized linear format. So if we look at the equilibrium line and we wish to express that in the form of y equals mx plus b, or a standard line format, we just need to go through and see how we can convert what we know about the equilibrium for the system into a format that matches this. In a dilute absorption system such as this, we often represent the equilibrium information using Henry's law. So if we try to make Henry's law look something like our form we have here of y equals mx plus b, when we compare these two equations, we see the Henry's constant divided by the pressure is actually equal to m, which is our slope, and then there is no offset for the equilibrium information, so that b value is going to be equal to zero. When we look up the Henry's law constant for this particular system, we see it's approximately 211, and we divide that by the system pressure, which is 1.5 atmospheres, and we derive the equation y is equal to 140.8x. This gives us a value of m, which is our slope, is 140.8, and b, which is our intercept, is 0. Now we turn our attention to the operating line. The slope of the operating line is just the ratio of the liquid flow rate to the vapor flow rate, and we've been given both in the problem statement. So the slope, L over V, is going to be 187.3, and then we can use the compositions entering and leaving the system to fully define the operating line of this system. Now that we've fully defined both the operating line and the equilibrium line in terms that are appropriate for a Kremser analysis, let's turn our attention to a Kremser equation appropriate for this system. Here we're asked to find the number of equilibrium stages required, and this particular Kremser equation gives us a solution in the form of the number of stages required. The first thing I'm going to do is evaluate this y star term. We're going to take slope information from the equilibrium line, the intercept information from the equilibrium line, m and b respectively, and also insert the inlet condition for the water stream, which is the composition 0 ppm. Once we make those substitutions, we end up with a solution of y star is equal to 0 parts per million. Now that we've evaluated that one equation, let's insert all of this information that we've accumulated into the one equation for the number of equilibrium stages for this absorber. Let's start out by evaluating the information associated with the operating line, and I'm going to start out with the compositional information in the top. We insert both the inlet and the outlet gas compositions, and then we can also insert that y star value we calculated, and we've evaluated the middle of that term. The other information associated with the operating line is the L over V term, which is our slope of our operating line. We see the L over V term in the denominator, represented here, but we also see the inverse, V over L, represented in the numerator twice. So that will be represented as 1 over L over V. Insert both of those into the equation, and finally, all we're missing is information associated with the slope of the equilibrium line. Insert the value we determined for m there, and we can evaluate this entire expression. When we go through and do all of the math, we determine the Kremser equation tells us that we need 6.1 equilibrium stages. When we go back and compare that with doing the same problem using a graphical method, we get virtually the same answer.